Welcome back to the One API channel. We used to have desktops, then laptops, then came the cloud, and now compute is everywhere. And it's not just the CPU. There are so many CPU flavors and so many accelerators, GPUs, AI accelerators, and more. I really want to use all of that compute power. Should it be that difficult? I want to code everything in the same place. I want to easily take my code from CPU to GPU or back to CPU. I want the code to be abstracted enough so I don't need to deal with cross-device communication and management. And I want it all to work fast, have good debug tools and analyzers. And this is exactly what we'll see in this series of short videos. There's much to talk about, so instead, let me jump right to the end. I want to show you a simple program running on CPU and GPU in 2 minutes. I'll get access to the Intel Dev Cloud, where I can work on a system with a CPU and a GPU. I'll open a Jupyter notebook and we'll run a simple SYCL program. Let's Google Intel Dev Cloud, enroll, it takes minutes. I will log in. We're working with one API. We can get multiple CPU options, GPUs, FPGAs, and more. Get started, launch the Jupyter lab, go to One API Essentials, to the first lab, One API Intro, launch the Jupyter notebook, and run cell after cell. The run simple script is running simple.cpp under the lab directory. Let me arrange the windows. And while the code is running, let's look at the code. Naturally, not everything will be fully understood, but bear with me. We are using SYCL. N is 16, and we have a queue. This is an execution queue to our accelerator. First thing we're doing is to check which accelerator, which device is connected, and print it out. And the device that is connected is a GPU, a P630 Intel GPU in this case. So this system has a CPU, this is the default, and a GPU. Now, we allocate an array called data, and data I is I. And now, we're multiplying each element of the array by 2. Fairly simple, but here is the magic. This operation is being executed on the GPU. The rest of the code is running on the CPU, but this specific parallel for loop is offloaded to the GPU. We're waiting for all the loops to finish and just print the results, 0 to 30, as you can see here. And that's all, one source code working on CPU and GPU, both working on the same array. I don't think it can get simpler than that. What's next? All the rest. We'll talk about heterogeneous and parallel systems. We'll understand why they are needed, what are the challenges to program, and how SYCL and Data Parallel C++ can help. Lots of materials online and a book you can download or order. See you next video.